Your life will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here.
Beloved, the time for your fulfillment and breakthrough is here, and it's now. It's the word of the Lord that he gave us last week, and we are on it. And we will continue to share it, and we'll move into the dimensions, hopefully next week, of all the people God has blessed. This week we are considering your attitude and the things you must do to prepare to receive. And those of you that are guilty, you will feel the conviction when the prophecy you said wasn't true, excuse me, will not come to pass right in front of you. You must cooperate with God in the lives of people of destiny. You must cooperate with God. Otherwise, you will be made ashamed, beloved. Oh, I feel the presence of God. I pray that you will experience it, even as you are listening to me, that your heart will soften, that where you made vows and said hard words, you can go back and repent, because God has come to visit his people. And he will bless some of the people you've judged. He will bless some of the people you've discounted and said they were no good and nothing will happen. You will see he will bless them. Hallelujah. It's in my book, Wisdom in a Bite. He said, God, Jesus died for the sin you are angry about. And he said, don't be angry when God blesses people you have disagreements with. Hallelujah. And verse 21 says, and they said one to another, we are very guilty concerning our brother. They remembered what happened. Oh, I love what a man of God said. He said, there are two records of sin. The one God keeps and the one in your mind. Boom, beloved. 20-something years later. There it is. Almost 30 years later. The thing was still live in their heart. The moment this happened, they said, yep. It's because of Joseph's blood. That's why this is happening to us. So we are very guilty concerning our brother, in that we saw the anguish of his soul when he besought us, and we will not hear. Therefore is this distress come upon us. Hallelujah. Come on, beloved. How have you done? The time of fulfillment is here. And Reuben answered them, saying, speak I not unto you, saying, do not sin against the child, and ye will not hear. Therefore, behold, also his blood is required. Ah, they understand spiritual laws. His blood is required. And they knew not that Joseph understood them, because they speak in Hebrew. For he spake unto them by an interpreter. And he turned himself about from them and wept, and returned to them again, and communed with them, and took from them Simeon, and bowed him before their eyes. Simeon chose him. That's where Reuben said he was trying to stop them. I don't quite remember now. I thought it was Simeon that, you know, Reuben was the firstborn. It was him that put him in the pit and thinking to come and get him later, because he was the one in trouble for sleeping with one of his father's youngest wives. So Simeon probably was one of the ringleaders, said, I want Simeon. So he took Simeon and bound him. Then Joseph commanded to fill their sacks with corn and to restore every man's money. He took them through all kinds of things. Let me just put it that way. He said, to give them provision for the way, and thus did he unto them. And they laded their asses with the corn and departed thence. And as one of them opened his sack to give his ass provender, in the inn he espied his money. For behold, it was in his sack's mouth. And he said unto his brethren, my money is restored. Hello, it's even in my sack. And their heart failed them, and they were afraid, saying, one to another. What is this that God had done to us? I love these Jews. Even Bible-believing Christians don't understand that. You ought to know that he's a God of covenant. You ought to know that when something happens, he has allowed it. Even when Satan has a right to do it because we have sinned, God still has to grant permission. That's what I love about them. They know that there's no failure in God. They know there's no defeat in God. They know that if all of a sudden the enemy is winning, the Lord allowed it. And so they say, why has the Lord done this? You find it in Samuel when God was judging Israel. And they went to the Philistines and were beaten. And they said, why has the Lord done this? They went and brought the ark. They were beaten again and thousands died. They said, why has the Lord done this? Because if the Lord didn't approve it, it won't happen. Forget this Satan-centric theology. Yeah? I know that he's the thief that coming to steal and to kill and to destroy. But beloved, why does he have room? He's walking about seeking whom he may devour. It is the breaches, the violation of spiritual laws, disobedience to the Lord. Your life is hid with Christ in God. If Satan doesn't have permission, he can't do anything. I'm teaching people, forget about the devil. Concentrate on God. Behold the Lord. Please the Lord. Work it out with the Lord. And Satan will remain a non-issue. And if there's an attack, then we find out what in the world is going on with us, Lord. What happened here? Then show us what to correct. And we will close the door and move on again. We don't build any altars over mishaps and discouraging things happening that happens to all people on earth. Come on, beloved. God is greater. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. Lord, you are higher than any other, beloved. It's such a wonderful thing. May God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. The Lord is waiting.